Hey there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video. In this video, we're going to talk about top 5 programming languages that you should really look forward to learn in 2018. Now, before you move ahead in this video, I will also mention that where you can implement those programming languages. This entire list is made on based on 4 criteria: the trend on the Stack Overflow, the trend on freelancer websites, the trend in the job market at MNCs, and the trend in the job market at startup. So really, the 4 essential things that we're going to talk about. Now, this is not only the list of programming language and their implementation. I have also got 5 honorable mentions. These languages were so amazing that I couldn't stop myself that yes, these languages really need to be get some credit there. So these are honorable mention at the end of the video. So without any further ado, let's get started. We can play. Just onto a side note here, it doesn't really mean that a language is at 5th position, that means it's a bad language, and a language is at 1st position, that means it's the best language. These are just the positions that I have figured it out. This doesn't mean it has to be true, you can completely disagree with that. So hear me out on this list. At number 5, I'm putting C# here. Now the reason putting up the C# here was not at all the .NET framework. In the recent year, I have seen that the popularity of .NET framework is reducing a little, not by much, a little. But the reason why I have put a C# here is because of game development as well as the Xamarin. Now, game development with Unity and everything is booming quite a lot, and that's why this language made it to the list here. Also, with the Xamarin, you are able to make mobile applications cross-platform, the Android as well as on the iOS, native apps using the Xamarin. So that is the reason why I'm putting up C# here. Amazing language, very easy to learn, and really, a lot of people who are already into the .NET market are now trying to move into the Xamarins or in the game development. So that's why this language made it to the list. At number 4, I would like to put Swift here. The reason behind putting the Swift is whether you're talking about top 10 programming language, top 5, Swift has to make the list. And the only reason behind that is Apple. Now, yes, I do agree here that there are a lot of haters of Apple on the internet, but we cannot skip the fact that Apple is a big deal. It sells insanely crazy high amount of devices every single year, regardless of whatever the price is or whatever the highest quality they are building up. They sell the product, and this makes a huge ecosystem for you. So if you're looking forward to design any apps that include any kind of Apple ecosystem, maybe that's an iPhone, iPad, maybe a game for Apple, or maybe any kind of desktop application, the Swift has to be here. There is just one way to go inside Apple ecosystem, and that is Swift. Yes, I do completely agree here that there is a big hurdle that in order to get into the Apple ecosystem, you have to have an Apple device. Whether it's a MacBook Mini, MacBook Air, MacBook Pro, you cannot just code for the Apple ecosystem outside the Apple ecosystem. You have to be inside it here. That's a big hurdle. Not everybody can afford Apple devices, so that's a downside. But still, the market is extremely huge. The jobs are really good. It's high-paying jobs, so that's why Apple made it to the list, and yes, we had to put it on number 4 with Swift. At number 3, I would like to put Java here. Now, alongside with Java, I would also like to put Kotlin here. So this spot is shared by 2 programming languages, Java and Kotlin. This is no surprise. This language had to be here. The Java is insanely crazy, powerful, and popular language. And especially the recent increase in the Android apps and the demand of Android developer, this language is growing like insanely. But not only because the Android, there are a lot of web applications being totally designed in Java. So that's why this language is gonna be on this list. But here's a quick word here that I would like to add on the Java. Now, if you want to become an Android developer, Java is a great start. But in order to make sure that you add a little bit cherry on the top of your existing resume, I would recommend you to learn Kotlin as well. The Kotlin is now officially supported language for Android development. And in fact, already a lot of companies have started to build up their side projects in the Kotlin as well. So if you want to get an extra edge as an Android developer, get started with Java, make a lot of apps in that, but make sure you also learn about the Kotlin as well. This will make you stand out from every other person who is there at the interview. This is really an essential edge that you should get. At number 2 in this list, I would like to put up JavaScript. Now, this programming language looks like is on steroids. This language is growing like insanely crazy. Now, the JavaScript that you are aware of possibly is not the JavaScript I'm talking about. JavaScript has evolved quite a lot, and with the 2017 edition here, it has evolved quite a lot. And there were a lot of flaws in the JavaScript. It was not the most personally favorite language for a lot of programmers, but it has evolved quite a lot. And make sure we are on the same page. We are talking about the 2017 and 2018 edition of JavaScript. Now JavaScript is perfectly capable and powerful enough to handle almost everything. You can work with the Node.js and can rely on the backend with it. At the front end, you can go with Angular or React and completely rely on this. This is really the hottest trend in the market. If you want to talk about the mobile apps, the Ionic framework or the React Native framework are completely capable of handling all the iOS as well as the Android app. And yes, there is a big reason why big companies like Facebook are completely shifting towards this JavaScript scenario and JavaScript globe here for their web, for their mobile, Android, iOS, everything. This language I haven't seen any language growing this much quickly and this much powerful. This language is growing quietly insane. Whether you talk about web or mobile, this is doing something. At our number one list, I would like to put Python here. Now, Python has to be on the top of this list, and the whole credit goes for machine learning. Now, this language is already super powerful. Whether you talk about the pen tester, whether you talk about the frameworks like Django for designing web apps, or maybe you talk about the analysis of the things like machine learning, NumPy, Pandas, this language has got a great comeback. Previously, this language actually showed a little bit dull sign in the recent time, but now again, this language is shining like anything. Talk about any companies, whether it's Google, it's Facebook, it's Apple, all the companies are after the engineers who have strong and thorough knowledge about Python. The recent startup are also aware that if they are gonna implement machine learning anyhow in their product is gonna scale up quite easily. They will get a high market value, and there are great chances that they are gonna be somehow being purchased by the big giants. So yes, without a single doubt in my mind, I would say that Python has to made it at number one in this list. Okay, so this is the list, but I do have 5 honorable mention, and I'll mention them really, really quickly because these are really good and they had to be here. 5, PHP, amazing, awesome, and still the highest projects on the websites like Freelancer and Upwork are in PHP, amazing. 4, Go, or also known as Golang, really powerful, can use a lot of your codes, and a lot of big companies are looking forward for the engineers of Golang. Number 3, R, really kind of a rival for Python, used quite a lot in machine learning as well as for data visualization. So yes, it's stealing a limelight of Python a little bit. Number 2, C++, implementation in game development as well as for high-end research like NS3, this language had to be here. Number 1, SQL, or also known as SQL. Really the heart of the internet still, and a lot of projects which are still in MySQL or somehow related, SQL is the way how you query to the database. Not specifically the programming language, but still the hottest trend on Stack Overflow. So had to be mentioned here. So this was my top 5 list of programming language that you should be looking forward to learn in 2018. You have full right to disagree with me, and I completely respect your opinion. There is always a thing about programming language. Some people favor one programming language, some people favor other programming language, and it's completely fine, completely okay. Don't forget to check out the link in the description below to download the Learn Code Online app for iOS and Android as well. There are also some of the links in the description below to learn these programming language. So that's it for this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Do share it with your friends so that they can also know what's going on, what's trendy in the programming market. That's it for this video, and I'll surely catch you up in the next one.